A big hello and a warm welcome to all of you amazing and beautiful people out there to my channel, the Twin Flame Union. And in this channeling session, the Divine Masculine is not shy or not stopping himself from complimenting the Divine Feminine for various things, but he is talking about her beauty in this channeling. And I also feel that you know, when they have gone through all the phases of different phases of Twin Flame journey, he had always wanted to tell her how beautiful she is. And maybe he did that too in different ways and forms. But in this channeling, he's going all out and he's completely, you know, he's healed. He has healed from his wounds and he does not have fears. He is comparing her with a flower and he's not mentioning the color of the flower, but he's saying that you are like a rose and you're a beautiful rose. And he's saying that, you know, your face is one in a million and your face is so dear to me because your face is like a beautiful flower. Even though we always say in the Twin Flame journey that physical beauty should not matter, but at the same time, you know, when you're in love with another person, it's really nice and sweet to give them compliments, to acknowledge them when they dress up, you know, to tell something nice to them. Even for the Divine Feminines, you know, they can say that you're looking handsome. And you're my handsome lover, my boyfriend or husband or whatever, you know, whatever you want to call them. He's in a very good mood actually. And I feel that somewhere he is also, you know, giving a mirror reflection of the Divine Feminine. Because in the past, Divine Feminines have also not openly appreciated the masculines, openly said those things to him when he needed to hear it. By the time they also shared their love for them, it was too late because he had already run away or he was in running away energies. And then she said that, you know, I do love you, I do love you, to convince him, to pacify him. And he was not getting pacified, obviously. Many of the Divine Feminines tried many ways by writing them emails, long notes and this and that, but it was too late. Then that was because the Divine Feminines never got that acknowledgement from anyone. And they were always never really told that you're beautiful or you're amazing or you're talented or you have this particular quality or that particular quality. And if they had to really get a compliment from someone, then they had to really ask for it. Please other people for it. And then they would get it. At the same time, somewhere this consciousness comes from the fact when we need other people's validation, then, you know, we want them to tell us that we are beautiful and then only we know. In this case, even the Divine Feminine is fully healed and there are no childhood wounds as such now. After a lot of inner work, you reach that stage. And this can happen at any age because you can be beautiful at any age. Beauty is a timeless thing. Beauty is timeless, ageless, but because of deep-rooted programming, Divine Feminine's beauty, as in the thoughts she has on beauty, were also unhealed. Like, you know, if she would think that, okay, I am at a certain age, I can't be beautiful, and then she's dating a younger guy, and she's not expecting, you know, obviously she wants him to compliment her, she wants him to find her attractive, but she thinks in her head that he may not find me attractive because I have certain age difference with him. And there are so many other such things, like maybe she's dark complexioned and in her part of the world, it is seen as a taboo or it is not seen as a good thing. Or maybe she's fair skinned and she's in love with a divine masculine who has a, you know, Indian origin or some other origin, Mexican origin, where darker skin, white skin people are not very, you know, seen as a good thing. There are some families who say that, oh, you should not marry a foreigner. You should only marry someone from our community. So these are just examples. सो वेन दे बोथ गेट हील्ड एंड दे कैन सी देयर ओन ब्यूटी विदाउट नीडिंग एनी वंस वैलिडेशन, दैट इज द टाइम वेन द डिवाइन मैस्कुलिन एंड डिवाइन फेमिनिन कैन ईजिली कॉम्प्लीमेंट ईच अदर विदाउट एनी फियर्स. You know, sometimes the masculine doesn't want to compliment her too much because he fears that if I compliment her too much, she'll start thinking that she's very beautiful and then she'll leave me. You know, same thing for the divine feminine. She's like, if I compliment him too much, he'll start thinking that I'm too good and then he will leave me for another woman. These kind of fears and traumas of rejection and of abandonment, both have them. Rejection and abandonment are literally the same thing. It's just different ways of perceiving it and different ways of reacting, which is why rejection and abandonment, you know, they sound like two different words, but actually they are very close to each other. They are similar fears, similar types of fears. So she's scared of abandonment, so for a long time, and she doesn't even know that, you know, if he's my real lover or if he's actually the one. It's only when things become too intense and there's too much fights and too much running away and she starts researching about the twin flame, she then finds out, okay, so this is the runner chaser dynamic. Okay, I must stop him now. I must not let him go. Okay, he could be my divine masculine also. So on and so forth. There are various reasons for when she compliments him. But both of them had restrained themselves from saying nice things to each other at the right time. They said it. They said it too. They said it at some point on the or the other. That's why they touched each other's hearts. And more than the words, it was the feelings that was, you know, the energy that was touching them. Sometimes they were even not saying nice things to each other. They were very mean to each other. But still, there was so much love. And even in separation phase, it has happened. And many people have shared their testimonials that, you know, I was thinking about her all the time. There are so many divine masculine, so many runners who have written their testimonials that, you know, I was always thinking about her. I was always so involved in her, even when we were not talking. And this is the reason why I went back to her. A lot of runners' testimonial is like this only, that I kept thinking about her even when I was with other people or even when I was not with her, and that urged me to figure out that this could be my one true relationship, you know, that I must pursue back. And she has the same thing, but obviously when she does the inner work, she stops focusing on him and she starts focusing on her own inner peace. Now in this case, both of them are actually hanging out in a beautiful place. They're just like, you know, traveling, and they're in a garden. They could be either traveling in a different place, they could be on a vacation. Both of them have just decided to step out from all the routine work they were doing, and they thought that let's take a break and let's go out somewhere. So she got dressed up and, you know, they're hanging out, or they've just simply met for a date at a garden or some outdoor location, some place. Even if they're in a crowded place, they're holding hands and they're with each other, they're in front of each other, even if it's a restaurant, you know, whatever the situation is. And for some people, if it's a beautiful day where they're doing a video conversation, they're just on the video call and she's beautifully dressed up, and he just spontaneously calls up at any given hour of the night also. Maybe he was not, you know, expecting that, you know, 2 o'clock in the night I call her and she would be looking so beautiful, or she would still be dressed. And we live in the online age. Somebody's making TikTok, somebody's doing Instagram live, somebody's doing just something or the other, somebody's just sitting and clicking pictures. It could be anything, you know, why he calls up. And he sees that, oh, she's dressed up so well, she's looking so pretty, she's looking like a flower herself. And look at her face, that, you know, those glittery eyes, that skin, you know, that glowing skin. And obviously after the radiant stage, the divine feminines, they glow a lot. Their skin is very beautiful. Even if, you know, they have some childhood scars or something, but there's a glow on their face. That is why that stage is called radiance. Because the divine feminines have this natural golden, you know, very beautiful radiance. Even if, you know, whatever complexion, it doesn't matter what is the color complexion, but the skin is very glowy. That's because when you do a lot of inner work and you're happy from within, you're smiling from within, it shows you know, on your skin, it shows on yourself, it shows. Even if you're simply dressed, but you will look so beautiful, you look so nice. And this happens with both. But because he's the masculine and he has accepted his role of the masculine, he's healed now. He has no qualms in complimenting her and she has no qualms in receiving the compliments. Earlier, yes, even she was complimenting him a little bit too much, you know. Or she was complimenting him when he was really angry or really upset just to convince him or pacify him. So he's complimenting her dressing sense, the way, whatever she's wearing. If she's wearing a bracelet, he's saying, oh, her bracelet is so beautiful. Your bracelet is so beautiful. It's really nice. It's looking so nice on your hands. And maybe it's you, because you're wearing it, it's looking very nice. I really like the way you've done your hair today. You're so pretty, my love. You're so cute. You're so adorable. You know, he's going on and on like that. At this point in time, the divine masculine, those who are probably in the outdoor setup, he's also saying that those who can, you know, who are physically sitting in front of each other, he's telling her that, you know, I really like how you smell, like your fragrance is so nice. He is not just talking about her fragrance as some kind of perfume that she's wearing, but it's her presence, the fragrance of her, you know, her body, her actual presence, that he's seeing as a fragrance. And again, this can happen even in a video call, you know, like even in a video conversation where they're talking to each other. And he feels that she has a certain presence and that presence has a beautiful fragrance. So he's complimenting that also, that, you know, I'm really liking it. It's so nice to see you smile in front of me. It's so nice to, you know, talk to you. It feels so nice. I love this connection. What is this connection? It's so cute. It's so adorable. It's so loving. Here, he also wants to say to the divine feminine that in all of these days, I have realized that the true color on this planet is the color of love. And once you wear that color, you realize that all the other colors, all the other things, everything else is a lie. It's an illusion. It's false. And because of you, I have realized this fact that love is the most real thing on this planet. In this world, love is the most real thing. And had I not met you, and had I not, you know, done this whole journey with you so far, every day that I'm with you, and when you say I'm with you, a lot of you would be like, oh, are we living together? Some of you still talk like that. I know, it's okay, no problem in that. When you're with someone, you're with someone. It's not necessary they're sitting next to you all the time. So he feels that ever since you're with me in my life, in my heart, I do realize very strongly that love is very real. Love is very strong and love is pure. He talks about the space and time. He says that, you know, time does not matter when I'm with you. Space does not matter when I'm with you. It's as if I feel myself in you and you in myself. And sometimes when I'm with you, time stops. When I'm with you, when I'm fully with you. And in many cases, the divine masculines are never really fully committed to the divine feminine. They've got fully committed to the karmics. They got fully committed to the false twins also. And this happened in the case of divine feminines also. When it came to false twin or karmics, they considered the commitment faster. But when it came to the divine masculine, I'm talking about the initial stage. And that's why the crisis also happens. They got little jittery. They were not that strong, even, you know, and that bold. Both of them were not that bold, that strong when it came to their true love. Because of all the bad experiences they received from the false twins and all the bad relationships, all the painful, abusive relationships, they were not ready to fully commit. And even though we say that the masculine is not totally committed, even the divine feminines were commitment phobic. A lot of divine feminines have been commitment phobic. That's why they've also been in very long relationships, many long relationships. If you have 3, 2, 4 long relationship, it means that somewhere it would have reached to a final commitment, but somebody backed out. And in most cases, before the masculine, it's obviously the feminine who must have backed out, you know. And if she had to end the relationship also, it was she who decided to step out of the toxic relationship eventually. That I cannot do this anymore and I think it's better that I step away from it. So when the runner-chaser dynamic happens, initially it's very frustrating because they feel that they have been perceived as a bad person, as a wrong person, or as a false lover by the masculine, which is not true. So they go ahead and they try a lot to convince this person also, in many ways. Even energetically, they are always trying to convince him somehow. When the face start changing, when the anger seeps in, then they start having mental fights with them. So it's like, that's why I say inner work is needed. That's why I say this trauma has to be healed so that you can become fuller. And when you see your beauty in full bloom, when you see your own beauty in full bloom, here in this channeling, I'm saying particularly for this energy, that the masculine makes certain vows to her. And he makes those vows based on the feeling of true love that he's feeling. So he says that only this love is real. And I would like to, and I want to, you know, commit to this love for the rest of my being. I will sing this song always. I will say the same things to you because you have shown me what is the meaning of true love. And of course, I will end this channeling by saying that he repeats it again. That your face is one in a million. Your face is one in a trillion. Your face is so unique, so different. It's not your face. It's mine. One love and peace out.